Khonius back. Today I decided to take a pleasure cruise around Ensenada, Mexico because I've never been here. That's where I've just landed on my trip. I'm flying a Cirrus SR22. Don't have a lot of experience with it, but it's small fun to fly airplane. I don't plan to get too high altitude wise, but plan to look around the city and see what it's like. I've never been here before. It's a little cloudy, but it looks very clear from here. Let's get ready to go here. Alright, I need to turn up the illumination on these guys. Be able to see during the day. Okay. Alright, and we should be ready to go. Let me take off the parking brake. Oh, okay, it's warning me about turning pilot heat on. I think it's cold outside. There we go. Alright, so I've got pilot heat on. It's about 2:30 p.m. local time here in Ensenada, Mexico. Flying in real time, real weather. Okay, this time I didn't put the flaps down. Let's see if that works okay. Okay, yeah, I don't think I necessarily need those for taking off these small planes. Got a good altitude going. So I flew into Ensenada last night from San Diego, actually really early this morning, in the middle of the night, in the dark. But the moon was out and it was actually very easy to see. So I'm gonna circle around for a while, gain some altitude, and then I'll head outside and we can look at what things look like.
I will contact you next when you leave my airspace.
Tower Katu 56, continue for south departure.
Stall.
Okay, I'm having a stalling problem. Like I said, I don't have a lot of experience with this airplane. I think my turn was a little bit too much for it. Alright, so got a good enough altitude. Let's go ahead and head outside and see what it looks like. Keep an eye on my throttle. I can probably pull back on that a little bit. Alright, well, I guess it looks about like I would expect. I don't know to what extent the AI has done a lot with this area, so it may not be very highly detailed. When I flew in last night, I didn't obviously see any other flight simulator players playing in this area. Looks kind of industrial down here. So this water line here looked really pretty from the air, so it's, you know, when I was flying in, so it's kind of nice to see it during the day, get a little closer. No idea what these streets are called, or the neighborhoods are called, or any points of interest. I don't see any marked points of interest, as a matter of fact. Just the other airport. Let's look down below again. See our shadow on the ground, see the cars going by. The water looks really pretty over here. Designed on the ground, looks like a giant clock or something. I don't know if it's visible this way? Oh, there it is. So I had to set a destination airport in order to be able to save the flight, but I'm not actually planning to go to that other airport. There's some airport nearby, I forget which one. Some more housing and whatnot coming up. Harbor down there with a bunch of boats. And so I've seen a lot more civilization over here. Maybe this is Ensenada proper over in this direction. I didn't really check a map. I'm so used to flying with autopilot on, it's kind of nice to hold on to the controls for once. I like the autopilot because it's very smooth, you can take nice shots with it, look outside. I don't have to worry too much about bumpiness. Boy, that area looks flooded. A lot of funny flooding effects in the game like that. The road near my house is supposedly underwater a little bit, which is interesting. This is looking very industrial out here, and then some farming. Maybe it's, you know, food processing or something. Cattle. Out and touch that cloud right there. It's interesting, this plane doesn't have a traditional yoke, it has a stick, so flying by stick myself is probably more natural in this case. See another freeway down there. It's starting to look a little less populated in this direction. Obviously a coastal highway going through. I'm going to start heading out over the water and circle back. So as you can see, there's the other airport. I should be able to request to land back at Ensenada. Or I could just fly over there. Rock formations and whatever down here. Maybe it's a quarry or something. Alright, I'm thinking of going in just a little lower. Get a little closer to the buildings, get a better look at the cars going by. Keeping an eye on my speed, don't want to get up towards the yellow. It's just very interesting to be able to go look at a satellite map this way, recreated in beautiful three dimensions. I'm hoping over time that more places will get the, you know, the hand-built treatment. I know they're about to release a Japan update. I can't wait to see what that looks like. I'm sure it's going to be beautiful. But I don't know when Mexico would get equivalent, maybe Mexico City, but not necessarily at Ensenada. No. Some kind of tanks down here. Or buildings, I'm not sure what those are. Feel the wind change when you go up and around these hills, and the, you know, the amount you have to change your push and pull on the stick to keep things stable. I'm gonna head over inland here a little bit. I see some water. It looks kind of interesting. A lot of population here. I'm thinking this might be the capital of Baja California. I'm not sure. Some kind of a lake or something over here. Like part of a water system. Got the graphics settings maxed out, so the volumetric clouds are really nice. I was, at one point I was flying and it was solid clouds and I started to get some stuttering, but that could just as easily have been in a delayed downloading something, so it's hard to say, but I haven't seen that since. Looks like maybe a bunch of housing over here. Finally increased the number of characters you could have on the tail of the airplane, so I've got my full gamer tag on there now. Alright, so a little less populated. Like a bunch of parcels with, you know, partially filled out, or just super large lots, I mean front yards or something. I'm going to go back in for a little bit, take a respite from the noise. Well, it's not much of a respite, I guess, in here. Trying to get experience though flying from inside and not relying on the outside view, which feels very video game like. This feels a lot more like flying. You really have to just pay attention to your instruments and trust what you know is down below you without having to look. So let's get a little closer and kind of go through this area and see what it looks like. Looks like it's starting to get overcast, losing our sun. So I do think I will just go land at that other airport. There's a pattern, so it's just right there. Alright, I'm going to climb a little bit because they're often entry point off in maybe 2,000 feet. Not that fast though. The co-pilot already took care of communicating with the tower. Yeah, the weather has really gone very bleak from when I started. Get some kind of an updraft. Flying through the clouds, that's really cool. I've not tried flying through a storm yet. My idea with these trips is to do it in real time and encounter whatever I encounter and deal with it. So we'll see what happens. I'll just keep taking, you know, short hops as far as I can. My goal right now would be to head all the way down to Brazil, Rio de Janeiro, and then head back up the other side of South America, but we'll see what happens. Okay, I'm going to start slowing down. I'm going to want my flaps to be down. So we're down on a good speed range. Just have to keep it in that white line with the flaps. I think it wants us to stay below 85, maybe. Maybe 90. The pattern will turn red, of course. Kind of cleared up, so I guess that's just patchy fog or something. Just adjusted the barometer, that's why the altitude suddenly jumped. I didn't really know to do that, I just know that periodically you need to because the air changes, and formerly I had the assists up on the screen to tell me when to do it, but I'm trying to get rid of those. So I just, every once in a while, get the barometric pressure updated. It's especially helpful when autopilot's on, it will automatically accommodate the change. Pretty out over the water, there's probably not much to see down below us, just watercolors. Look to the left, a nice view. And then out towards the Pacific. Yeah, there's a little island there, I'm not sure what that is. I'm not going to investigate it today, but sometime I'd like to fly out there and see what that's all about. Turn into the landing pattern, trying to balance throttle, altitude, flap effects and everything. I do need to drop altitude and especially speed, and so I'll do what I need to slow down. The turn will help. So we're still too fast, but okay, there we go. Now we're in range. At some point, I imagine turning off the landing guides, but it would be really hard for me to know where to go if I turn those off now.
Mike Yankee Zulu traffic, Ka 256 is on final runway 12 to land.
So we're good on speed, I'm not overly high and have to drop extra altitude. So if I can just maintain this, not go too far down below the green into the white. So wind seems to change as you get closer to the ground. I need to do a little bit of homework and learn a little bit about ground effects of air and some of that aeronautic stuff. Alright, I think I see the landing strip now, that looks good. Alright, I'm definitely too fast or too high, so let me drop power and just kind of glide here for a bit.
Hundred.
so we're still doing good stall wise. I think I'm gonna run out of energy a little bit, so I'm gonna just get a little bit of thrust. I do not want to completely lose lift. But you also want to land as slow as you possibly can, so it's just a trade-off. Go outside to land. Alright, so I'm going to try to float as long as
stall,
I can.
Stall.
Alright, I think that was a good landing. Little bit, get a better overview as we're taxiing. Alright, so I'm not sure where to go from here. Let's look at here. Now it's taxi. Okay, there we go.
Mike Yankee Zulu traffic COD 256 is taxiing to runway 30.
Oh, now it's
Mike Yankee Zulu traffic COD 256 taking off runway 30 left
right
touch
thing.
And go.
It's not a, it's clear of runway.
Mike Yankee Zulu traffic COD 256 is clear of the runway.
Alright. I think it's up to us to just go wherever we want. We're not going to get assistance from anybody in our tower. So let me go outside so I can see better and we'll figure out where to go. I mean, it's just a landing strip, right? Where are you going to go? I kind of think we're done. Alright, well that was my quick tour of Ensenada, Mexico. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video in Mexico.